It is absolutely amazing to me that it got this cold this quick. Like, I'm not a cold person, and I can't only wear a sweatshirt anymore. I'm absolutely freezing. So I was gonna go and ride these new trails. There's new, I think they're technically mountain biking trails, but I looked on the website, it doesn't say anything about electronics or whatever, or engines or anything, so forgiveness instead of permission, that sort of thing. Anyway, I was gonna go ride them. I spent the entire day editing yesterday's vlog, which was the conspiracy theory one that Metal for Breakfast helped me with. If you haven't seen it, go watch it. It's funny and awesome, and like, I'm really glad that I took the extra time and got him in it, because A, it sets up our Break the Internet collab like perfectly. B, it wouldn't have been the same video without him. Long distance collabs are hard. The internet is slow and makes me mad. Still worth doing. I'm just down here at the river, you know? If you can't ride the trails, just come ride the river. Cool rainbow happening right there. What I wanted to talk about was this whole, and I kind of talked about it in the binge-worthy video, but I didn't go quite as deep as I wanted to go. Fanboying, about idolizing people, that sort of thing. I just realized why it happens. When you dedicate so much time, like it used to just be movies, right? Like you'd go spend, you know, 10 bucks or whatever to go and watch a 2-hour-long movie, and you see these actors and they do such a good job and you're like, man, I just love them. So people would idolize actors. Now, I'm talking about YouTube. I'm talking about like what we're all doing here. And without fail, in fact, Roberto said this very thing. What is one of the things you've encountered that you haven't ever, that you weren't prepared for?
Probably the actual reaction of the way that I make people feel is still weird. Like people coming up to me and saying, hey, I recognize you, that's still weird. And people being excited to see me, like people I don't know being excited to see me, that still is a fresh feeling. And it's weird. It's not bad weird, but it's like still a, oh. You know, being treated that way, like I still see the same dude when I look in the mirror. I think a lot of creators, we still see all of our flaws, all our insecurities, all the things we don't like. I still see the dude who got his butt kicked at the bus stop every day. Like, so when someone looks to me the way that I think I've maybe looked to somebody that inspires me, being on the other side of that is actually still really weird, and I don't think I was ever really prepared for it.
Without fail, it feels very weird for someone to treat you like something that you know yourself you are not. This is what I realized. The reason we do this, I think, has to do with content consumption. Like, if I'm willing to give Casey Neistat 15 minutes of my day for like 2 years, you know what I'm saying, when he was daily, or for, in my case, it was like, you know, 3 hours of my day for however many months, because I binge watched all of his stuff. In our minds, to justify that, we're like, yeah, he must be like really something super special, because that's why I was willing to give him that much of my, there's definitely something amazing and inhuman about that person. Like, they must be radical. But the quicker we can all realize that we are all just people, that we are all not just people, I always have a problem. I don't like to say just, people are amazing, you know? Talk about impact, like impacting one person, that is a huge, we are all people and creators, we're all in this thing together. That's why I love No Small Creator, I love the community. Like, I just found this new guy today and he commented on one of my videos, and like what he said really, like really got to me. I went and clicked on his channel. He had this video called Why Do I Create? I'm gonna put a card to it up there. Incredible video, absolutely incredible video. Plus his name's Oliver. I mean, everybody loves a person with the name Oliver. Oliver is such a radical name. That's what I wanna talk about. I'm gonna ride back, I'm gonna go have dinner with my family. You really didn't miss anything today. I was sitting at my computer editing. That's what happened. Thanks for sticking with me. Hit like, drop a comment, hit subscribe. Let's do this thing. All right, I thought I was done with this video, but I wasn't. I'm nervous that some of you watching me, or watching Pete, or watching Casey, or watching Sorrel, or Lizzie, or Lucy, or Audrey, anybody that you love watching, I'm nervous that you watch us and you're like, yeah, they've just got something that I don't have. And that isn't true. That couldn't be further from the truth. Sure, we have different personalities, we have different friends, we have different skill sets, like, yeah, I put in the grind, all that stuff. But at the end of the day, You are just as watchable. You're great. You're valuable. You are just as valuable as me, okay? And as anybody that you love watching. There's not something other than maybe time and experience, you are not less than anybody else, okay? Good night, or good morning, or good evening, you know, Truman Show.